Welcome back, It's Not, and today we are going to be discussing PlayStation's inevitable summer event that is going to be happening. As of right now, we know it's not going to be a part of E3, but we know that there's likely going to be some sort of event in the month of June or even sometime in the summer in general, as that is a major time for video games to be showing off. And while they had missed the years before, this is the year for them to make a comeback and really show off something because they have a lot to show. And whether that's a part of E3 or not, it doesn't matter. If it comes into State of Play form, that's more than welcome as well. Now, before we get into that, if you have not subscribed already, please hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell to get notified about all my upcoming videos, and hit the like button. It helps the channel a ton. Now, let's get right into this. And we're talking about PlayStation and PlayStation 5 games that are up and coming and how we could see a barrage of information trailers to happen this summer. Now, obviously, these are not confirmed. So just to point that out there now before I get those comments saying, hey, these aren't confirmed, you're just talking. No, this is speculation, of course. But it's speculation with, it's an educated speculation, let's call it, because we know that there's a lot to be shown off, games that we have not seen yet. June is a big month for E3 and other type of gaming showcases, so it makes sense for Sony to be ready to show off some big hitters of theirs. Now, as you all know, we've seen a few of Sony's games. You know, Demon's Souls is one of the big ones that came for the PS5. Returnal comes out at the end of this month, Ratchet and Clank in June, but that leaves, you know, a couple left that we have not heard anything about that has not officially been delayed or anything like that, which is Horizon Forbidden West and God of War for the PS5, or subtitled right now by most, Ragnarok. Now, the thing is, number one, both these games are huge. They're massive, massive titles. There's no two ways about that. Horizon 2 or Horizon Forbidden West is one of their biggest hitters, and God of War is probably, I would say, one of their top ones, like top two for sure, in terms of studios outputting games that are critically acclaimed, right? So those are two games that we are bound to see. Now, it depends. Are we going to see anything about these games? And I think, truthfully, I genuinely believe if there is, in fact, a showcase, that we are going to definitely, most definitely see Horizon Forbidden West and we're going to see God of War Ragnarok. And let me explain why I believe that to be the case. Number one, Horizon Forbidden West is allegedly, according to Sony, and they are where the buck stops, right? Going to release this game in 2021. This is going to be a cross-gen game between PS4, PS5. And we have not seen anything since the initial reveal. Now, if this is in fact to be on schedule, like we are believing it to be, and there's been no signs of a delay, and, you know, Jim Ryan in his latest interview, which was a while back, did talk about Gran Turismo's delay, but he did not talk about Horizon Forbidden West being delayed. In fact, he talked more about Horizon 2. So it makes me believe that it's probably on track. And he also, if I'm not mistaken, confirmed that it was on track at the time that he had the interview. So it makes me believe that this game is due in 2021. If that's the case, we're getting up to that moment where they need to start saying, okay, this game is coming out such and such date, you know, and showing off more footage, maybe a gameplay trailer, maybe just another trailer in general, maybe a nice PlayStation blog post detailing a lot of different things. These are things that I can totally expect in their next showcase. This is a given to me. I don't think there's any two ways about this one. This one has to be there. Now, God of War Ragnarok is a different story. This one is a game that we've been told is due in 2021. Lots of people in the industry saying that that's not happening. It's been delayed. It was never intended for 2021, but nothing straight out of Sony's employees' mouths. So if we're to believe what's being told to us, this is expected to be 2021. While I am doubtful, we're going to go on the narrative that this is coming out in 2021. So if that is indeed the case, and even if it's not, even if it's delayed, let's just assume that it goes either way. They are likely going to show off a trailer for God of War Ragnarok. It has to happen, right? Like, if this is a game that originally is intended for 2021, they are certainly far enough along that they can show us a trailer. So I believe that God of War Ragnarok is going to be on the showcase presentation as well. I think that whether it be a minute trailer, whether it be an extensive trailer, it doesn't matter. They're going to give us one, and if it comes with a 2022 release date, guess what? Nobody's going to be upset about that. Well, most people won't be upset about that because they're going to get a look at God of War Ragnarok. They're going to be excited, and we're going to forget all about the fact that it's being delayed because it's going to look so badass, and I have full faith in Sony Santa Monica because they just did such a great job with the PS4 God of War. So that's another game that I believe to be at the E3, or not E3, the PlayStation showcase that I'm expecting will happen this summer, hopefully in June, just for the timing of everything. Now, we know that Gran Turismo got delayed. I could see that getting another reveal, naturally. We know that Insomniac Games is dropping Ratchet & Clank June 11th, but they have another game in production. I don't think we're going to see that here. Forspoken, you know, it is a PlayStation exclusive. I really think we're going to get another look at that. I think Final Fantasy 16 is going to get a release date. Very, very likely that we're going to see a 2022 release date, which puts another massive hitter alongside Forspoken, also known as Project Athia, in 2022. So this is already coming to be a massive 2022 based on the speculation, also based on some facts that we know as well. Now, there are many games in production at PlayStation that we have not got release dates for, we have not got announcements for. Hell, there's some games that we don't even know what they are. Like, we just know there are games in production, there are new IP in production that we don't know anything about. Now, The Last of Us Remake is another game that allegedly, we'll say, is in production over at Naughty Dog. So that's going to be a game in the in-between of their next big game that we're likely going to get from them. So this shows how dangerous Sony is and how dangerous PlayStation is. I know there's a narrative around right now that PlayStation is basically just going to do sequels, or they're focused just on making big hits. Therefore, they're going to return back to their IP that have been big hits, like Uncharted and The Last of Us and stuff like that. But let's be honest, with the job postings we've seen, that's definitely not the case. So we already know that London Studio is working on a new IP. That's one of the big ones there. We also know that Sony Santa Monica is also working on a new IP. We also know that Naughty Dog, for all we know, could be working on a new IP, as they have allegedly 3 to 4 projects on the go, according to their own interview by Mr. Wells. So really, that's not even speculation. That's basically extracting information from the interview that he did. So we know that there are a lot of projects on the go right now. And that's kind of what my point is here. So although the narrative has been that, when we look at the facts, that's really not the case. So this is what makes PlayStation such a competitor, such a powerhouse for new releases and new games and big games and new IP, right? So I'm telling you right now, based on the stuff that I know and, you know, covering PlayStation like pretty much meticulously through these past, I want to say year and a half, and the information that I've gathered is that PlayStation always has some big hitters that they don't disclose to everybody. And then when their showcase comes up, when the cards are against them in some cases, they really blow everybody away. So I have full confidence in them. And also, like, I just feel like this is it, right? This is going to be the event that really pushes forward the narrative that PlayStation 5 is the platform with the most exclusives, despite not having the most studios, right? And we're going to see that going into this summer showcase that I believe to be happening. Again, this is speculation. I haven't been told by anybody, just to clarify. I don't want anybody to take my words out of context. But this is something that I do genuinely expect. But that is all I have for you guys in today's video. I'd love to hear from you. What do you guys think we're going to see this summer? Do you think PlayStation is going to have a showcase? What do you think they're going to show off? Could we see a God of War Ragnarok gameplay trailer, or a trailer in general with a release date? Could we see a Horizon 2 release date, gameplay trailer, all that good stuff? Could we see some of the new IP that they're working on? I want to hear what you guys think in the comments. And as always, if you have not subscribed already, please hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell to get notified about all my upcoming videos, and hit the like button. It helps the channel a ton. You can follow me on Twitter and Twitch. Links will be in the description. And share this video with a friend. I will talk to you all on the next one. Take care.